What's up, everybody? You're back at the Simone Show, and I am here with Detroit's own dance and in the street, Martha Reeves.
Hi, Simone. And the fishtail just went up at the rooster tail where they sprinkled the water, the waterfall.
Yep.
It just happened, and I was hoping to see that before we left.
Uh-huh.
We're here taping.
Yeah.
Get out the vote campaign.
Mm-hmm.
We're celebrating 100 years that women have had the right to vote.
Yeah.
We marched and we protested and everything to get the right to vote.
Mm-hmm.
And thank God for that, because it's 100 years. Happy, happy anniversary to all the women in the world.
Oh, that's awesome. And I want to ask you a few questions. Is that okay?
You better ask me some questions.
Yes, girl.
Okay.
So, what's one of your most memorable performances?
Oh, God. I can't do that, you know, because I've been singing since I was 3 years old.
Uh-huh.
And when my two older brothers and I, Vinny and Thomas, one was candy at my grandfather's church.
Yeah.
I was three, Thomas was five, and Vinny was seven. And when the people in Jesus met the woman at the well, was the song we sang.
Yeah.
Da da, I met the woman, da da, at the well. Hey, hey, Jesus, met the woman, and we won candy. So, celebrating. 50 years of having won the contest in Metropolitan Amy Church at our grandfather's church. We won the canyon. If they weren't nice to me, I wouldn't give them a chocolate covered cherry. That was my favorite candy, and it still is.
Oh my goodness, yeah. They're delicious.
You got brothers?
I don't. I actually.
You know what you're missing. I had six brothers, and I could only beat up two of them.
I wish
that's because they were young and they kept picking at me.
Baby.
Yeah.
I wish I had some other siblings.
Okay.
It would be so much fun.
Well, you're blessed. You got some more coming.
Yeah.
It's wonderful. Yeah.
What's your favorite person that you've met during your journey?
Oh, my God. It might be Jesus face to face.
Yeah.
Yeah. 1977, I had the experience of having my name called, and I was moved to go on a prayer retreat. And it's important I tell people, because some people don't know that there's been a change in me.
Yeah.
Yeah. When I was baptized, I left a lot of stuff in the water. A lot of stuff. I was dipped down. I came back. A whole lot of stuff was left right there in that pond. Ooh, it was cold too. It was. Yes, it was. But I realized a lot of things, and I've been changed. Where I know why I sing. I know why I perform. I know why I'm eager to lift my voice, because it pleased my mom.
Mm.
She taught me how to retain lyrics. Mm. It impressed my elementary school teacher, Mrs. Wagstaff, Emily Wagstaff. She's a little short German lady. She wasn't no taller than us.
Oh.
But she taught me how to sing a lot of songs, like the anthems. She taught me this one song that makes me feel real good about us trying to get people out to vote.
Yeah.
It was a song called This Is My Country.
Mm.
People have been telling me all my life, go back to Africa. And see, it's because they had a bad habit of trying to put people down. But then I was letting them know I ain't been in no Africa.
Mm-hmm.
I've been to Africa. You know, my mother and father didn't know nothing about Africa, and I was asked to go to Africa, but I wouldn't go because of the apartheid hadn't been settled. I wasn't going to another country to see a segregated audience. I'd seen enough in America.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided, no, I won't go to Africa until it's straightened out. It is now. And no, we didn't name Vandela after Mandela. No, we did not. And Vandela is a word put together. Van Dyke Street and Della Reese, who I idolized. Yes. And that story should be told, because what else could a Vandela be?
Right, because now they know.
I see, okay, that's what I'm talking about. Tell the world.
And I know in your office you have so many trophies. It's awesome. What would be your favorite one?
I don't know if I'm as good an actress as I think. I did attend Lee Strasberg's Theater Institute. I didn't get my degree because my grandfather passed away and I had to leave Los Angeles in a huff. But I do know that if called on, I could do acting.
Yes.
But I'd just like to be fair, be called a trained vocalist and a teacher of the arts.
Okay.
Because most of the things I've learned, I taught. Give you an example.
Okay.
Motown had a school, right, called Artist Development. We would have 2 hours with each instructor. We had Maurice King and Johnny Allen, who would teach us music theory. So you got to know the difference in music from an A to a J, or ain't no J's, and do the scale that's on it. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. Yeah, it's okay. So you got to know that, though. You got to know where they go in your voice. You got to go to know where they are in the music and in the melodies of songs.
Right.
And every song I've ever sang, I tried to sing the melody that the writer wrote.
Yeah.
Because that was their pain, and I could express it from a woman's point of view.
Right.
And I think that's a success of a lot of my collaborations with the different writers and the different producers. Because Motown had 17 writers on staff. Barry Gordy paid 17 guys to come there every day for a salary and write for some talented people that they went out in the street and found. They went to different talent shows and found. I was found at a nightclub because I won a talent contest. Because I was 21, my reward was 3 days in a nightclub called the 20 grand.
Yeah, because when you was performing, you was like, I'm a nightclub kind of girl. And I was like, I know.
When we were performing, I was letting you know that that's some of my roots. But at that age of 21, I didn't know what I was going to be because I was just out of the church.
Right.
And I knew my dad wasn't going to let me go and sing in a club until I was 21.
Mm-hmm.
So I had the opportunity and I took it.
Yeah.
So they gave me a reward at the amateur show. We had to have a contest before we could be something in Detroit.
Yeah.
The Warfield Theater was the theater. And anybody had been in some of those amateur contests.
Mm-hmm.
And I won, so my reward as a singer, I was Martha LaBelle.
Yes.
I was not a jazz singer.
That is.
I sang Gin House Blues, Canadian Sunset, because I thought Canada was part of Detroit.
Oh.
Until 911, we could go over there when we felt like it.
Yeah.
Now you gotta have legal passport and everything else.
Everything.
Yeah, the world's changing. It's changing.
For real.
But I'm glad to be here to see the changes and to make the adjustments.
Yeah.
Yes, Simone. Somebody's calling me.
Ooh.
I'll let them go on. Yeah, we get it.
Okay. So what advice would you give to like young upcoming artists like myself? What would you
get as much education as you can? Everything I've ever learned, I've had to use. Like, how would I know when I was in high school and had a commercial course? I decided to get a commercial course. I learned how to write out checks. I know how to count money. I know how to keep records. I know how to take dictation. I know how to take shorthand. I had a commercial course. So what happens? I get discovered singing somewhere, and the first thing they do is take me to a studio and tell me, what are you doing here? I said, don't you remember giving me a card and inviting me here to this company? This is the morning they gave auditions. It was like 30 people outside with their, you know, waiting in the cold, waiting to get an audition. But here I walked past because I had a card.
Right.
I'm business.
Girl, she said, I am here. The talent has arrived.
Where's Mr. Stevenson? The girl say, you mean Mickey? I said, if that's what you call him. Where is it? So she busts a little door, because this is Barry Gordy's house, mind you.
Yeah.
Push the door, bust it, and I walk out there, the same man, same suit on, the same, had taken his jacket off, loosed his tie, asking me, what are you doing here? I said, don't you remember giving me this card last night? This man ain't been home. This man been up all night writing a song for this drummer named Marvin Gaye.
Oh, I
see. People are creating and entertaining. They don't care what time of day or night it is. When that creative juice flows, you got to do something with it. You can't, if you don't write a song down that you write in half asleep or like in a daze, you won't remember it. So you better record it then when you write it, or you better write it down when you sense what it is that you're, what's tugging at your heart to write.
Yes.
And you got that bug already, so I'm just trying to let you know that adults have that too.
Yeah.
And they start at a very early age, so you're right on time.
So,
you're right on track.
And you know it's always nice talking to you, girl. I love you so much.
My baby's so grown up.
Anyway,
I love you, Simone.
I love you, too. I'll see you guys later. Bye.